change your mind. Streaming right now, so we have all of you watching at home too, so we're sorry you can't be here, but so glad you can join us online. But yeah, I am so excited to be here. My name is Amanda Shaw, and this is my band, The Cute Guys. Y'all make some noise for The Cute Guys, y'all. Okay, so at every show, I always start off by saying how excited I am to be here and everything. But tonight really is a really special night for me because this is the Cajun Zydeco Festival. So getting to come back to my roots where I really started playing music, going back to some of the songs I grew up learning how to play, it truly does make tonight a really, really special night. And I'm so excited that you guys can join me here. Y'all give it up for the Jazz and Heritage Foundation, y'all. And also give it up for WWOZ, who's also a partner in this. So I grew up learning how to play like Cajun music, and I learned how to sing the songs phonetically, and I'd love to just take a minute to acknowledge that while I don't speak French, I appreciate it so much, and I want to acknowledge all of those out there who still continue to speak Cajun French and the work that they do for Cajun culture. It's just such an important thing, and I appreciate all the work that they do. But like I said, I love Cajun music. I grew up listening to Cajun music. I love the energy. And tonight I'm excited to take you on a journey through Cajun music, through my eyes, and my 20-year career, y'all, here, which is incredible, I know. So as a matter of fact, I'm gonna kick things off with a song that I put on my most recent full-length album, which happens to also be my first ever full traditional Cajun album. I sang in French. I learned how to sing some songs I had always wanted to learn how to sing. I put some songs in there that I grew up learning that I loved. And so anyways, this is one of my favorite songs that I put on there. I probably fell in love with it first when I saw Jimmy C. Newman perform it on the Grand Ole Opry. And I just thought, well, that is so cool. And it gave me perspective that Cajun music was just, it was beyond the boundaries of Louisiana. It's something so many people around the world love. So, and I also loved the way he sang it. He had like a growl in his voice. He said, "Hey, mama." And I just thought it was cool too, as a 10-year-old. So anyways, this is one of my favorite tunes on my album, Joie. This one's called Grandma Moo. tonight, y'all. me out. Man, how about Build a Turk, y'all? That introduction, y'all. We go back a long way. Although, I don't know, I feel like you took all my stories for my show, so I have to make some new stories up about myself. This one time, no. So a lot of times people ask me how I got started playing Cajun music. And I was a kid. My mom, I was taking lessons at Southeastern at the time. I was taking violin lessons. And my parents would take me down to like Mulots, Michaud's and Mulots, and they'd have like the Cajun dancing and the Cajun bands and stuff. And so one of my favorite Cajun bands was Shadi Buddy. They played on Sundays at Mulots. And my mom would take me down there, and the fiddle player, Mitchell Reed, would give me a lesson while the band was setting up and sound checking. And it's really cool because, we'd pick a song and for him to teach me, and he'd play a couple notes, and then I'd play him back, and then he'd play a couple more notes, and I'd play those notes back, and, went on and on, and then by the end of the lesson, I'd know a song, I'd learn a new song. It was on the hallway, the stage was next, it was in the back of the room. I don't know if y'all have ever been to Mulots over there, but you know where the stage is. There's a little hallway that leads to the bathrooms right there. That's where my lessons took place, by the bathrooms. So not a lot of tip money in bathroom performances, y'all. I'm just going to throw that out there. No. But anyways, it's so cool. And, I loved Shawty Buddy. I loved Cajun music. I loved going to go see, people dancing. I loved the energy of Cajun music just from the get-go. Something about it, as a kid, it also kind of reminded me of, rock and roll. I grew up in a house with a lot of eclectic music. We had everything from Queen to, Beau Soleil playing, on our playlist in the house. But, something about Cajun music, just really made my spirit so happy. And it's really cool because, obviously, what I didn't appreciate as, an 8, 9, 10-year-old at the time was that, Mitchell sharing those songs, he had learned those songs from Dennis McGee, and, they were neighbors, in Lafayette, and he taught me those songs, and, that's part of the tradition of Cajun music, right, is learning them, sharing them, passing them on, and it's so cool to know that I have all these songs now, and I get to continue to play them for audiences all over the world, and share those stories and everything. So we're going to play one of the songs from my band that I like, Shawty Buddy, and there's a very long French name for it, but we just call it Mewe.
Oh,
called Bayou Tash.
Thank you.
Thank you. So just to be totally honest, you know, as I said earlier, I grew up playing Cajun music, and I love Cajun music, and I love Louisiana, and I love being from Louisiana, and it inspires me to everything that I do in my life. And one of the things that kind of happened is when I was 13, I got signed to Rounder Records, and that was pretty cool. And I started learning about songwriting, and it was also the first time I heard Dolly Parton's album, Jolene, in full, and I was just like, how does she know? How does she know how I'm feeling? And the power of songwriting and what it can do to someone's life, a great song, right? And just thinking, golly, if I could ever write anything ever, ever remotely that ever made anybody feel anything, that would be awesome. So I fell in love with songwriting when I was 13, and I started doing songwriting sessions for my album, Pretty Runs Out. And like I said, though, no matter what, Louisiana always inspires me, whether it's the rhythms or the melodies or the stories that I tell. It's something that I take with me everywhere. So anyways, since I write music too, I wanted to play some originals for you guys tonight. And since this is my first, you know, my first album that I put out with original music when I was a kid, I got to play it for all my fans who've been following me since those days. If you've ever seen me at a show, I always tell you, you know, I dedicate this one to everybody who's been following me since I was this big, you know, because I know there's a lot of y'all out there, and we're very intimate tonight, so you can tell I am still that big. So this one's for all of you guys who have been following me since I was this big. This one's called Pretty Runs Out.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Part two is going to be pretty gets expensive. I went to Sephora the other day and I put it on my credit card.
The way you smile, I forget all
dancing all night long till you could see how lucky you are to be with me again. You can hear me. See how lucky you are to be with me again. This time around you're gonna treat me right, like I'm the only girl you ever saw. So mind your manners, open my door, and while you're at it, please call me Miss Shaw. I'm putting on my dress, my high heels, and you're picking me up at 10. We're going dancing all night long till you can see how lucky you are to be with me again. You can hear me laughing, you can watch me dancing. I can tell you're thinking I look good. And I'm betting that you're wishing you had never tried to be just friends. You ought to see me at my highs, and you see me at my lows. But now you better see how lucky you are to be with me again. Oh yes, you better see how lucky you are to be with me again. A little two beat in there, you know, do it right. All right, so this is a song for a long time so many fans asked me to play and record and we finally did, and I love this song so much. So again, if you're a dancer, this one's for you. This one, it's one of the best Cajun songs. This one's Jolie Blonde.
But y'all, it is still hot, y'all. I didn't bring my little fan in because I was like, oh, it's an inside gig. Like, I'm like living the life tonight, you know, in New Orleans. But I just wasted $60 worth of makeup tonight.
Thank you. De ma quitté pour ton aller.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you.
Y'all look so good on the dance floor. Y'all really do. Things I like the most about Cajun music, and something that's always really inspired me, is the stories. And a lot of times they're really simple stories, but they're true to the people that wrote them, you know. Life was hard, you know, especially when things were coming up, right? They were out isolated out in the West Louisiana area, and it was a community on its own, and they really only had each other. A lot of people were farmers, you know, so they worked really hard, like every day, all day. And then they would have like fado dos on the weekends, right, where everybody would get together just like this, having a good time. Everybody would bring their instruments. And I mean, like, how cool is that, right? Like, in a lot of ways, nothing's really changed. I mean, life is so hard. We're not farmers, but a lot of us, but, you know, life is hard, and a lot of us still use music to cope with things, right? And so it's still so true. Like, so those songs feel really timeless to me. And, you know, our problems, again, we all have problems, but our problems have changed a little bit. And so that's one thing I always keep in mind when, like, I'm writing songs. So I've been writing a new record. I'm a little gun-shy about talking about this because Bill DeTurk called me out in his intro because I've been writing my record in Nashville. No, I've had a really awesome opportunity, but y'all, I think the thing is that I'd like to say is, like, I still live here. I plan on always living here. You know, this is my home, and no matter where I go, it's so important to me. And like this last year when I've been working on my record, I take Louisiana with me everywhere I go, and it's the core of who I am, and I don't care where I am. That's never going to change. So now that I've said that, okay, so I have been working on this record. I've been writing these songs, this next song I wrote, and I'd love to share it with you guys, even though it's not out yet, and I know we're live streaming this, and I had a tug of war about whether or not I was going to play this song tonight because, you know, it's not out yet, but it's so special to me, and I'd love to share it with you guys tonight if that's all right with you guys. So as I said before, you know, problems are always problems, and life is always going to have its problems. And I think something that we've all been talking about a lot lately in, like, social media and whatever, and in social conversations, is, like, I think we all struggle with feeling like we don't fit in, you know, sometimes, you know, which is really funny that we all feel that way, right? Like, that we all feel that way. And I'm no different sometimes, you know. I just say something silly or whatever, not say something and question, oh my God, like, what did I do? And I'm gonna make this version of this story real short, but what inspired this story was my mom used to make a lot of my costumes, like, for Halloween and stuff growing up as a kid, and I was, like, super embarrassed about it. I was like, oh, you know, because all the other kids, they went to, like, Party City or whatever, and they got, like, whatever was in the catalog. I'm dating myself, right? They'd send out the catalog, and, you know, you'd pick out the outfit. My mom got this brilliant idea the year that the Toy Story movie came out, that we were going to be, I have a younger brother, and we were going to be Bo Peep and Woody. And they weren't even making that costume, so they weren't even making, like, the material for this costume. So my mom, like, hand-painted the little pink dots on the skirt and everything. She used a wine cork to put it on. But anyways, so I go out, and I mean, there's a picture of my brother and I. Y'all, we look as unhappy as two kids who are about to get a bunch of free candy could possibly look. And so, but we go out, we go to the first house, and the lady opens up the door, and she's like, so cute. And she's like yelling to her husband, get the big candy bars, come out here, get the big candy bars, you know. And so we get the big candy bars, you know, go to the next house, and same thing happens, you know, and we get extra candy and all of this, you know. It's like, oh my God. And you know that happens a few more houses, and you know, we're finally getting the hang of it. my younger brother even, I think, throws in like a howdy instead of trick or treat, you know? We've now, by like house number five, we've completely bought into this thing. So anyways, the moral of the story though is that everybody liked our costumes because nobody else had those costumes, and they were handmade costumes. You know, everybody else looked the same with whatever was at Party City that year or whatever, but that year we got all the extra candy because our costumes were handmade. And just like that, I thought about how we are all handmade and that we all deserve extra candy sometimes. So, but we are, we're all handmade. Regardless of your flaws and your insecurities, it's perfect because you are you and it's just the way you're meant to be. So this one's called Handmade.
Fragile lace, tired gold, quilted fabric in every fold. It may look rough, but it's made with love. Mismatched buttons, broken hems, out of style, but it's broken and it ain't quite right. Oh, but it's all mine. We're all tattered, bruised, and worn, and we've all been insecure. We're just tailors trying to make our way. You're not meant to be one size, 'cause we're all one of a kind. Every piece is there to do with what you may. Life is handmade. Racks of things made real fast. Ain't a thing made to last. Those perfect seams, well, they ain't what they. We're all tattered, bruised, and worn, and we've all been insecure. We're just tailors trying to make our way. You're not meant to be one size, 'cause we're all one of a kind. Every piece is there to do with what you may. Life is handmade. You may have a broken stitch, but that don't mean you need to be fixed. We're all tattered, bruised, and worn, and we've all been insecure. We're just tailors trying to make our way. You're not meant to be one size, 'cause we're all one of a kind. Every piece is there to do with you may, so make it your very own way. Life is handmade. You're better handmade.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
This is the Louisiana in me coming out right now. So long story short, because I don't have time to tell the whole story, but I got to meet Dolly. Like, what is life? And when I met her, I forgot how to talk.
I forgot what my name was, and Kent was helping me out because at so much point she's like, "So what are you doing here, darling?" And I was like, "Oh right, yeah." And Kent's like, "She's from New Orleans. She plays the fiddle, you know." And he's helping me out. So anyway, so Sally says, "Oh, that's so great. Are you writing all your own songs?" And I was like, "Yes, ma'am, I am. I'm writing all my songs." She's like, "Well, you know, back in the 80s, I was down in Louisiana for my TV show, and I met all them Zydeco guys, and you know, I like that music, and I wrote this cute little song. Kent, you should show it to her. You know, you should record that song. If you're looking for songs from the outside, you know, you should think about recording that song." And she's just like, did Dolly Parton just pitch me a song? Like, I'm nobody. And so then a couple weeks later, I was back in Nashville, and Kent goes, "So you thought any more about that song?" And I was like, these people are serious right now. Like, this is serious. So again, this is my Louisiana in me coming out. I was like, and Kent's on the record, and I was like, "Oh, look, everybody sounds really great on that song." I was like, "But you know, if you wanted a real Cajun song, like, you should obviously, like, have folks from Louisiana come play a Cajun song and come play this tune, and we give it a real Cajun feel to it." And if you don't know anything about the business in Nashville, I'm going to tell you something. Nobody uses their own band. They all use session musicians. So here I am. I'm like, "Come on, guys. We're going to Nashville, and we're going to go record a Dolly Parton song that Dolly Parton gave us, you know?" And so that's what we did in November. We brought Louisiana to Nashville, and we did our very own version. So we made a little Cajun Dolly Parton for y'all right here. Okay, now you can go.
I've been through hell in half of Louisiana looking for a man like you. I know you can have any woman you want, and I know you've had a few. Thank you. just when you think I couldn't love you any better, well, I have just begun.
Thank you. Thanks, Dolly.
Should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. But you got to let me know. Sing it! It's always taste, taste, taste. You're happy when I'm on my knees. One day it's it's black. So if you want me off your back, then come on and let me know. I want to hear you this time. Decisions bugging me. If you don't want me, set me free. Exactly who am I supposed to be? Don't you know which clothes even fit me? Oh, you got to let me know. Should I cool it or should I blow? Should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble. But if I stay, it will be double. Oh, you got to let me know. Come on, y'all, sing it. Thank you. tulip.